the same feeling that as an adult I would get walking through customs with heroin in my bottom. I'm getting away with it! I've got loads of delicious heroin! Here's a tip for you, okay? This is a very useful tip. It's actually only any real use if you are a drug addict. If you're not a drug addict, don't think, ooh, that's a good tip. I'll become a drug addict in order to employ the tip. That is false economy. But if you are a drug addict, here is your tip. Say, right, if you're a drug addict and you've got to go on holiday, right, you got to have some drugs with you, ain't you? Otherwise the holiday will be spoiled, right? But because of them squares in customs, it's very difficult to get the drugs to be on the holiday with you. And you must have the drugs, but you must have a safe way of transporting them. That is why I suggest that you use your special back pocket, Jesus's internal wallet, the corridor to Narnia. Because I think this, right, say you're in an airport and you're walking about, right, and a customs official approaches you and says, come this way, please, sir, and takes you into that room, one bit mirrored, one bit glass, one bit mirrored, one bit glass, one bit mirrored, one bit glass window. Why have that one bit mirror, one bit glass, one bit mirror, one bit glass? Like, say if you walk past it, it's like a flick book for perverts. Right, if the customs official takes you into that little room, puts on the unforgiving cold rubber glove, like an evil sooty show, past your buttocks, inserts two digits, uses the scissor and twist technique. Hey, this is just an anecdote to you, I live this shit. Right, and carries out a thorough cavity search inside your bottom, and you haven't got any drugs up there. That's still going to ruin your holiday. By the time it gets to that stage, you might as well have drugs up your ass. A fingernail might puncture a bag and take the edge off an otherwise difficult experience. Plus, in an airport situation, it's difficult because of sniffer dogs, right? Sniffer dogs present us with a curious dichotomy. This is a split idea. I don't mean to be patronising, but I do like to cater to the thick. Not I'm suggesting anyone is. And if you're offended by that, then you have to go, I'm offended by that. And then the caveat must be, because I'm thick. So by being offended, you've sort of acknowledged that you are thick. And none of us are, so we're all back on speaking terms. We're all delightfully clever. Yeah, because if you see a sniffer dog, right, it's a difficult situation, especially if you've got some heroin in your bottom, because you sort of think, right, on one hand, you think, oh, no, there's a sniffer dog and I've got all that heroin in my bottom. But on the other hand, you sort of think, oh, that dog's got a job. Have you got a job? Have you? Are you doing your job now? Is this your work? Oh, no. You're working 9 to 5. You're working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. Would you mind coming this way, please, sir? Sniffer dogs? Dogs don't should have job. That's as bad as your grammar, cat. Dogs don't need a job. A dog is just a dog, isn't it? Plus, even amateur dogs will do some sniffing in their leisure time. And I don't like that, because they put the guilt on you. Like, if a dog start probing you here with its snout, like, why have I got to bear the burden of the guilt? He's doing it. I ain't sniffing his nuts. And you go, oh, smelling my dog, he's smelling your cock. Unless your dog is living in your scrotal sack. I don't think you should have a sniffer dog, because a dog shouldn't have a job, right? And why? Why in our lifetimes, our human lifetimes that we're all enduring and enjoying together, was there a program? Why did this happen? There was a program on our TV sets called Dogs with Jobs, right? bulbs, and they used to put it on at 11:30 in the morning, right? Now, I was unemployed at that time, and I resented a programme called Dogs with Jobs being put on telly when they knew unemployed people would be watching. Like eating Weetabix for the 40th consecutive day. Just keep putting the Weetabix in so don't die. Like a baby bird. In a programme called Dogs with Jobs. Come, oh, fucking hell. Even the dogs have got jobs.
Sandy is 7 years old and she's a vital member of the paramedics team. Without her, the ambulance simply won't leave the hospital. Fuck off, Sandy, you scab.